Hi everyone, welcome to my presentation for Power on Your Plate, Traditional African Vegetable Summit. My name is Herbaud ZOHOUNGBOGBO. I'm Research Assistant in Plant Breeding at World Vegetable Center Benin. I would like to share with you my study on andromonoecious in Gynandropsis gynandra and effect on fruit and seed production. My presentation will follow this outline. After a general overview, I'll present to you the material and methods. And after that, I'll present the result and discussion and finish by a short conclusion. A basic understanding of the flower structure, breeding system, and phenology is very important for understanding the life story strategy of a plant species. Plant reproductive morphology can depart from the hermaphrodite pattern to produce various sexual types among flower, individual plant, and population. And knowledge of sexual system is an essential background for evaluating the dependence of seed production on pollination rates, and also understanding the mechanics of gene flow within and between populations. Many of the plant species that are cultivated for food across the world are neglected and underutilized, and the information about their sexual and mating system are scarce. This is the example of many traditional African vegetables. And between them, we have Gynandropsis gynandra, which is also a traditional leafy vegetable widely used in Africa and also found across a phytogeographical area of my country, which is in Benin. Gynandropsis gynandra is said to be polygamodiosis, representing functionally staminate short gynoecium floral type and functionally hermaphrodite medium and long gynoecium floral type. These polygamodiosus sexual system supported by high fruit and seed set rate in hermaphrodite floral type indicated that Gynandropsis is self-compatible and autogamous. This also was confirmed by Omondi and Earl in 2017 that Gynandropsis are self-compatible or at least partial self-compatible following the classification used by Lord and Choen. However, we tried several attempts to do this self-individual plant for this species, but it results in very low rates of success. And this helped us to initiate and the clarification to see what is the preferential mating system in Gynandropsis gynandra and provide guidance for the development of efficient breeding program for the species. So we address the following question: do floral structure, phenology, and sexual system influence fruit initiation? How does pollination system affect fruit and seed production? To which extent seed germination in the offspring is affected by the reproductive method in Gynandropsis gynandra? To attain our objectives, we use three accessions, which is from three different countries. One accession was from Laos in Asia, and two accessions were from West Africa, Benin, and Ghana. We used two experimental sites for this work, one at the University of Abel Kalapi and another in Alada district. The experimental design we used was a split plot experiment with four randomized complete blocks. Each block was divided into three main plots with five subplots per main plot. Pollination experiment. 750 flowers were observed, including 50 flowers per accession and per pollination treatment. Five pollination types were used: self, hand autopollination, geitonogamy, cross-pollination, and open pollination. As you observe, self-pollination was the pollination using a bag without pollination from hand pollination. The pollination should be done by the plant, by the flower themselves, and hand autopollination, which is the pollen, we cover the pollen and all the flower, and then we use the pollen from the covered flowers to do the pollination. The geitonogamy, which is to use pollen from another flower from the same plant to pollinate the flower from the same plant. Cross pollination, which is to use pollen from another flower from another individual plant to pollinate one flower. Open pollination, which is the flower left to the natural pollination. Pollination can be done by one of pollinators. We collected data on time to fruit maturity, fruit set, length of the pod, diameter of the pod, and the number of seeds per pod. We performed statistical analysis. using descriptive and statistics, including mean and standard error, were calculated for only quantitative traits. Data of stamens length and pod length were normally distributed, and we use analysis of variance and generalized linear models to inspect differences among accession and treatments. As a result, we observe that we have two types of flower in all the three accessions we use. We mainly have staminate flower and hermaphrodite flower. Between the staminate flower, we have two types of staminate flower. We have staminate flower with short gynoecium and staminate flower with long gynoecium. Between the hermaphrodite flower, we have two types. We have the hermaphrodite flower with medium gynoecium and the hermaphrodite flower with long gynoecium. We also make a type of flower in three at the end, the long gynoecium, medium gynoecium, and the short gynoecium. So flower webs separate in three types using the length of the gynoecium. So when we make this type of flowers, we also recorded the data on the stamen length, the ovary length, the gynophore length, the gynoecium length, and the androphore length for the each type of gynoecium that we have. So for the three accession, we observed that there is no difference between stamen length, ovary length, gynoecium length for the three types of flowers that we observe based on the length of the gynoecium. We also try to observe the different phenology phase that we can have from the apparition of the bird to the full flower for Gynandropsis gynandra, and we observe that we can have six stages. Stage one is the calyx formation. The stage two is the peduncle elongation and flower bed enlargement, the development of ovary. The stage three is the elongation of petals, stele, and stamens. The stage four is the calyx, which is changed color from yellow to white. And the stage five is the anthesis. The last stage, which is the stage six, is the senescence. Between the stage two and the stage one and the stage two, we have 3 to 4 days. And between the stage two to the stage three, we have 1 to 2 days. Between the stage three to the stage four, we have 1 day. Between the stage four to the stage five, we have 12 hours to 1 day. And between the stage five to the stage, we have just 1 day. When we observe the five pollination type, we observe that open pollination gives us the higher fruit set for all the three accession. For the accession from Laos, Asia, we have 99%. From the accession from Benin country, we have 97%. And for the accession from Ghana, we have around 86%. But in contrast to this result, in the natural self-pollination, we have a low fruit set, especially for the line from Benin, we have 23% of fruit set, and for Benin we have around 56%, and from Laos, Asia, we have 51%, around 51% of fruit set. So comparing this, we can see that open pollination give a high chance to flowers to have a high fruit set, but natural self-pollination is quite difficult for gynandra flowers. When we observe the germination rate from the offspring of the different type of pollination type we have, we observe that they are quite low. We have 24% of germination for accession from Laos, Asia, 25% from the accession from Benin, and around 30% from the accession from Ghana. But we observe that there is no difference between accession for the germination rate, and also there is no difference between treatment for the germination rate. The low germination rate in Gynandropsis gynandra is quite a big problem, and also the time for the conservation can influence the germination rate for the species. What is the floral phenology of Gynandropsis gynandra or Cleomaceae gynandra? Our direct observation in our experimental site indicate that Gynandropsis gynandra was an andromonoecious plant with three categories of flowers: functional staminate with short gynoecium, functional hermaphrodite with medium gynoecium, and functional hermaphrodite with long gynoecium. So in general, we have short gynoecium flower, medium gynoecium flower, and long gynoecium flower. So it's three categories of flower that we observe in our tree accession. So, and knowing that andromonoecy is a sex expression in which both hermaphrodite flower and male flower are produced in an individual plant, we agree in our study that Gynandropsis gynandra is andromonoecy plant. But Raju and Rani in 2016 reported that Gynandropsis gynandra is polygamoecious, consisting of andromonoecious individual producing both staminate and fertility hermaphrodite flower type and fertile hermaphrodite individual. But in our case, we didn't observe the hermaphrodite individual with either medium gynoecium short stamen flower type or medium gynoecium sessile stamen flower type in our experimental fields. We also observed that Cleomaceae can be grown through the year, and immature birds can take 2 weeks to mature into flower. Vegetative growth, flowering, and fruiting even can occur simultaneously in the individual plant. This is also observed by Raju and Rani in 2016. And also in our study, we observed that the anthesis was nocturnal anthesis for all the accession we used. From the bird to mature fruit, we have about 21 to 27 days. If it were, we observed that open pollination flower in Gynandropsis produce more fruit and seed than hand pollinated flower. The reduction in seed number in hand pollinated fruit compared with the open pollinated fruit may indicate insufficient pollination to serve all the ovule that was observed. Geitonogamy gave a high fruit set for all accessions, suggesting that in the condition of high demand of pollen, a plant can easily ensure offspring with contributing of the wind and pollinator. Gynandropsis gynandra is capable of self-pollination. For instance, natural selfing was possible for all the accessions, but result in low fruit and seed set. In addition, hand selfing gave high fruit set, suggesting that Gynandropsis is self-compatible. In conclusion, Gynandropsis gynandra benefit from both self and cross-pollination to ensure its reproductive success. The fruit set of Gynandropsis gynandra by open pollination was significantly higher than and fruit set of the self-pollinated flower. The andromonoecy of Gynandropsis gynandra offer a range of possibilities for to future breeding program targeting the species. Thank you very much for your kind attention.